Hey guys, welcome to channel update on Southern Alberta pike and walleye hunters here. Getting pretty close to the season opener here. It's probably about 2 or 3 weeks away. So I've just been stocking up for that. I've been watching a lot of fishing shows and gathering some information and just kind of getting my tackle arsenal ready for the season opener there. It's been a while since I saw there. I thought about fishing the bow, but I'm not much of a fly fisherman. I'm kind of more spin casting, bait casting type of guy. So just figured I'd give you guys an update on season opener here. But like I said, I was talking before about I had some vehicle issues that happened right at the start of the season. So there was a lapse in episodes and stuff. Prior season, I probably got out three times as much, and I'm going to be definitely doing some new lakes this year and fishing for maybe a few other species of fish we have here in Alberta. There's not too many other than pike and walleye. Like I said, I'm not much of a fly fisherman, and I don't kind of go that way. I've got the fly rod. I've taken the course, but just haven't been able to get out and yeah, I went a few times in the bow, but that was kind of a train wreck. So actually thought about fishing the bow a few times, but like I said, it's I think it's with this global warming that's been happening, we've been getting very cold weather lately. So hopefully some of this ice melts off here, and the main focus I'm going to be having for beginning of May here is the spawning walleye. And going after some big pike and some lakes that we've got here. A lot of our lakes in PP1, PP2 or zero limit. So it's very fun fish to catch and target. And I always learn something new every time I go pike fishing. I've got some lures and been watching some fishing shows on pike and walleye techniques. So I'm definitely going to be sharing that with you guys throughout the upcoming season here. Actually looking at getting a new belly boat here pretty soon. I had a valve that was that came off on one that I got from Amazon. I used it one season before a couple times and packed it away, put it into my stuff, and lo and behold, one of the valves was missing, and I tried going on there to talk to the manufacturer and the guy who sold it to me and all that stuff, and they couldn't come up with a piece for that, so that's kind of toast. So probably going to be looking to get one of those ones. But the issue with fishing some of these lakes in southern Alberta is we got the wind currents down here are really strong on reservoirs. So unless you've got a kayak or a boat or something, that's pretty sturdy. You get kind of blown all over the lake. But I know some places where I can go to fish where the wind's not really an issue. So that's something I'm going to be focusing on in this upcoming season too. Also, I'm going to be doing a lot more barbecuing in the season opener here. I didn't do much of that some of the other episodes due to insect and weather conditions permitting. It just depends at the time and stuff like that. To pre-plan for a trip, you got to get a recipe together and kind of do all these things that some of these other channels are doing, and that was just kind of poor planning on my behalf. So coming up here, I'm going to be getting together a list of stuff that I'm going to be doing to get some more episodes out, some of my subscribers here. So just figured I'd keep you guys in the loop. I'm not just kind of dumping my channel off and stop fishing because, you know, the views are going down or anything like that. I love to fish, and this is probably one of the better times of the year to go fishing. It kind of dies off around June or August or whatever, but that doesn't mean that there's always lakes to fish and new things to learn and new techniques to try. So I'm going to be sharing some of that knowledge with you guys. So so coming up here May 8th, it's that's when the season opens up here in Alberta. Might be moving to a afternoon shift possibly, so I might be able to get up in the morning and do some stuff, but it's probably primarily going to be weekends and stuff like that. Like I said, make sure you guys get your fishing license there. You can get them online or Canadian Tire, the Fishing Hole, and stuff like that. I'm going to be doing a ton of new lakes and going to be doing location spots, stuff like that for new places. Probably ones I'm not going to be heading to as often as some other ones. Like I said, some fishermen have their spots, and broadcasting it all over YouTube is not something that, fishermen can't share all the secrets, you know what I mean? So it's, you kind of have to do the work on where you go and where the fishing is good. But like I say, Elsa Albertans, we're very blessed with a good fishery of lakes and reservoirs. We've got a zero limit and a very good conservation program that kind of keeps a majority, keeps the sport fishing active and good for guys like me who like to do catch and release. Some people like to catch and keep, and that's their business. And if they decide to do whatever they want with that, you know, nobody can really do anything about that. But, coming up in the season here, hopefully we can get out to some new lakes and try some new things. I was actually thinking about, it's been done probably more than once. I've wanted to check out the Len Thompson headquarters there in Lacombe, Alberta. That'll probably be one of my upcoming episodes that I'm going to do for that, as well as I'm not really a river fisherman per se, but I've had some viewers tell me to go down to the South Saskatchewan River there, and apparently the fishing's pretty good for there. I've never caught a sturgeon before, so that might be on the bucket list. I haven't done a guided fishing trip in a bit here, but there's a couple lakes. Like I say, one of the knowledge I want to pass on to you guys is, if you're subscribed to fishing shows on your TELUS package or something like that, the Outdoorsman program is a very good program. It's got a lot of really good fishing shows, some of them in the U.S., a couple really good ones here in Canada. One of those shows, I think, was called the Canada Fishing Show, and Dime Store Fishermen, and Fishing the Wild West with Wes David. He does a lot of shows in and around Alberta, and I've learned some stuff. Buzz Bomb Tackle and Len Thompson and different techniques and stuff like that. So, in the downtime, there's stuff you can do to kind of up your knowledge for when you're going to go out and go fishing, where you're going to go fishing. But more or less, a lot of the people in southern Alberta are probably going to be targeting the bigger lakes like Lake Newell and Crawling Valley Reservoir. Some spots that mainly a lot of people go to that know about. Maybe you've seen a couple of them in my episodes that I've gone to. No local fishermen will probably be aware of those ones. I'm going to try and not be the same guy who fishes the same lake all the time. But sometimes, it's when you need to get out there and, you know a place to catch fish. People don't really like seeing channels, I guess, where nobody catches any fish. But I'm going to try and vary it up. And, I've been really into barbecuing here in this last few months. So hopefully I can show you guys some stuff I'm going to be making and stuff like that. And stay tuned for that stuff. And I haven't been ignoring you guys. It's just during the downtime throughout the season and not having a vehicle, it was tough to get out and make episodes. And you kind of needed a vehicle to do that. I had an SUV that I love very much. And unfortunately, there were some issues with it, and I had to get rid of it. So, but now I'm driving again, so that's good. So hopefully I can get out and fish some lakes and some reservoirs for you guys, and show you guys some stuff. And appreciate you guys watching my channel and support me up to this point. But yeah, we are going to be heading into full tilt here probably in about a week or two. So I'm just kind of giving an update on what's going on with everything. And been getting quite a few emails asking me when I'm going to be posting a video again, and when I'm going to get out. And I got some viewers there in the Middle East, and they wonder what the lakes are like here and what type of fish we catch and stuff like that. So I appreciate a lot of their support, some of those guys that watch my channel. And I'm going to be getting out to post some videos and some info on that. And other than that, that's all I got for you guys. And hopefully we see you guys. I am going to be doing some gear reviews and some tackle you know, that I purchased recently that I've seen, and I'm going to be trying it out in some pike infested lakes that we have here in Alberta, and hopefully they do the same as what I saw in some of the fishing videos I saw. I'm going to be mainly a shore fisherman as far as I know so far, but the belly boat is it's on its way. Ordered one there from Amazon, so it should be coming sometime soon. I thought about getting a kayak, and that's kind of in the mix, but I guess we'll see kind of what happens with that. So, but I should have some content here hopefully up in the next 2 to 3 weeks. So thanks for watching. Keep your stick on the ice.